Ladies and gentlemen, Q-Words. do you want this to be the intro? Is that cool with you?
Sure.
Cool. What's up, Q-Word? How are you doing?
Doing pretty good.
We haven't talked in a while.
Yeah, it's been like months. Yeah. It's Halloween, I think.
That's fine. We don't talk about that.
Yeah.
How are you doing?
I'm pretty good. Just hanging out. Drinking water.
Oh, I'm drinking beer.
Keeping it moist. Are you drinking beer?
Yeah. Do you drink beer?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. You were wasted the other day, right?
Yeah, I did.
Did you have a party?
Mm-mm. No. Just stayed at home playing games.
And you just drink on your own? My buddy Zeus does that. That's wild. Well, I guess I smoke. I mean, I do it too, I guess, but I don't get wasted.
Yeah. Weekends, I usually end up drinking and playing GTA with Jiklis, and we just he stays up to like 5 in the morning just to play.
You guys play GTA 5?
Yeah, we usually just drive around and run over people and shit.
Right. Do you try to make money, or are you not into that?
We actually make a lot of money. We got to a point where we just do like one heist, and we can just keep milking that.
We can talk about this. I've played this game, by the way. We can talk. Do you have a bunker?
Yeah, man.
I was so into it, but they banned me. The fucking guys banned me, Rockstar, because like a modder dropped me money, and like, you know, it's a modder dropping money on me. You know what I mean? And I get it, but then to permanently ban my account that I had invested so much energy into, and then I just decided to let it go and stopped giving a fuck about the game. But I love that game, man.
Yeah, it's pretty fun. It's gotten kind of easy as long as you have somebody to help you in the beginning.
Is that right? Because I always thought that the game was like had a really, like, always, you know, upgrading a skill ceiling, right? Because they add more expensive shit, more stronger shit, like, you know what I mean? Like, everything becomes stronger and crazier.
It kind of was at that point. I remember, the game is kind of fucking stupid now, because you have to literally grind for shit for hours just to make, like, 100,000.
Wait, what?
To even make any money to get any cool cars and shit.
So you don't have, like, facilities and stuff. You don't have like bunkers and like car.
Yeah, not really.
Ah, okay.
I skipped ahead. I did like, there's just one heist that you can take advantage of as long as you have like a friend helping you. In the beginning, then you can just start doing it on your own and grinding it, and you can get like a couple million. You get like 2 million from one run, I think.
Oh, which one is that? The Diamond Casino heist?
It's the KO Perico.
Is that a new one?
Probably since you've played last, I think.
Damn, I don't think I finished the heist. For some reason, it was bugged. Yeah, I don't know, man. Fun game, though. Do you have one of those scooters? Like the flying ones?
The Fagios?
No, man. The flying ones. The classics, right?
The flying ones. Yeah, we have the... I got one of those. I don't really like those because it kind of ruins the game for me.
It does, yeah. But it does feel like... Immersion-wise, for me, like, as an identity thing, it feels so cool to be, like, this crime boss, right, on this... I had this chromed-out flying bicycle, you know what I mean? And I had the motorcycle helmet and a big fur coat, you know? Like, that fantasy is so fucking cool, man. And I'm flying through this huge map, and there's so much to do, so many people, like, so much chaos.
Oh, yeah.
It is fun, man. Man, I wish I still had my account. We could play together.
Yeah, we could.
Anyways.
That would be kind of fun.
Yeah. I'm never gonna get it back, though.
Yeah.
I mailed them already. They just don't respond. They say, isn't that kind of shit? That should be kind of legal, right? I mean, it's not that big a deal. Like, there's bigger things, like, in the world. Like, Ukraine, for example. I'm sure we'll talk about that. But like, how can you just ban someone and then say, no, you know, we won't tell you why you were banned? You know what I mean? We won't let you contact us. Like, what if they make a mistake? You know?
I think the main problem with them is they're just a shitty company or something.
Are they actually Rockstar? Or is that just shitty?
I think Rockstar is just being shitty. I think there's just been a lot of things that have happened in their games to where it's just like, it's probably not the best for players, I guess. I don't know.
Like what? Like the more expensive danger shit. Like the now you can, if you have a lot of money, you can summon an orbital strike, right? Crazy shit like that.
Oh yeah, you can't actually do that.
Yeah, that's wild.
It's actually fun. I like doing that shit to people. That's pretty fun. Once in a while, me and Jiklis will be the people who fuck people over.
Oh man, yeah. I mean, same. you know.
That happens. Yeah.
Happened especially a lot for me, man. Man, if I was angry, like this, I haven't played this in a while, but why, if I was angry, I went to GTA 5 and I had all this expensive shit, and I just like, fuck all you people, you know? Man. Mm-hmm. It's a good game.
Yeah.
Yeah, Q-Word. Okay, tell me about you, Q-Word. Tell me about you. Do you got a job?
Yeah.
What do you do?
Yeah. Do Minecraft work right now.
You're making commissions. Yeah, you mentioned that. What does that mean? I haven't seen that. I will commission you. Are you expensive? Maybe I can't commission you because I have bills to pay, Mark.
Yeah, you should probably pay the bills. You shouldn't.
Yeah, no.
You make Minecraft stuff anyways. You're fine. But yeah, I work for like one or two marketplace teams.
Oh,
just
really?
Making. Yeah, just making.
How do I not know? How do we talk all the time and I don't know this shit about you? You know what I mean? How does that happen?
I don't know. I guess I feel like a lot of people just do work for marketplace teams.
Is that true? Because you're a Minecraft partner, right? That seems like such a big deal. Or is it just?
I guess I am. Not really.
Is it just? No ghost. Sorry.
No, they just pay me to make shit a lot of the time. I don't really make things for Mojang. I make things for the little marketplace teams.
No, I get it, but it's interesting that it's relatively easy to just be an artist and be unique, because you couldn't use the default textures, right? For example.
Oh yeah.
So my pack could never be on there, for example, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess that's why it's not in my hemisphere. Does that make sense? You know what I mean?
Yeah. That's it, yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's pretty neat.
Well, I have a YouTube channel making
yeah
loads really? Of money. Yeah, really. So do you, actually.
How's that? I do.
How's my... Were you going to ask how my YouTube channel is working out for me?
What's that?
Were you going to ask how my YouTube channel is working out for me?
Yeah, I was going to ask that. And you interrupted me.
Yeah, but I brought it back, right? I'm here for it.
Okay.
All right.
How's your YouTube channel doing?
Hey, man. Thanks for asking, dude. Yeah, it's pretty good, and you know, just chugging along, as always, just making fucking videos, and, you know, promoting the fuck out of it. I went on RuneScape recently, I don't know if you caught this, but I went on RuneScape. You know RuneScape? You know what RuneScape is?
Yeah, I've seen it around, I think, yeah.
It's just, there's a game and there's an in-game currency, right? And I have a shitload of in-game currency, because I used to have a really bad habit of, like, spending way too much in real-life money on video games. I moved on from that. Now we can talk about it if it pops up, but yeah, I'm now selling people 1 million in-game currency to subscribe to my channel, and sometimes they're like, you know, they barter, you know, but then I'm like, okay, you're more committed, and you know, maybe it's worth the money, you know, since you're more committed, you know what I mean? So yeah, YouTube's good.
So one, you're giving people 1 million in-game currencies.
RuneScape money, RuneScape gold pieces. Yeah. To subscribe. Not anyone watching, just like, if I meet you in RuneScape, yeah, you don't know me yet, you know what I mean? I mean, I'll give
you
a
million. I don't even know how much that is. It sounds like a lot. It sounds like a lot of RuneScape monies.
No, that's actually not that much. Like, I couldn't do it on the members world. That's where paid people go, right? Because they laugh at me. But like the noobs, you know, you get in there.
Oh, right. Get them noobs.
Yeah, but you gotta catch the noobs. How are your parents?
Good. One's good, yeah.
Where are you living right now? Can you talk about that?
I live in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah, you told me in like, we talked about that.
I'll show you where I live, in the middle of nowhere.
Okay, without doxing yourself.
I got like a farm out there. What? Chicken coop with no chickens in it.
What's in the back? What are the buildings in the back? Solar panels?
That's the house back there.
Oh, yeah, dude, those are sweet, dude. I haven't seen them up close like that.
Yeah, they're pretty huge.
Cool.
Can you still hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. I can hear you.
In the bank.
Yeah, they're dope. That's really cool, man. Good content right here. What are the buildings in the back?
Those are houses of other people.
Oh, so you do have neighbors, but they're like really like hillbilly maybe? Or maybe not?
Yeah, they're pretty hillbilly.
Alright.
They're hillbillies. I've been up there. They have like campfires and they do fire pits and stuff.
Oh, that sounds fun though, right?
Whenever they come up, it's a vacation house for them. But when they come up, They've got like fire pits, and they just drink and sit around fire.
Wild. Where's the nearest store from where you live?
Oof. It's pretty far. I can't walk there. I have to drive there.
Because you're not in a village. You're literally a house, and then there's another house, right?
Yeah, it's just all houses around here.
I bet you relate. Have you played Stardew Valley?
No, not really.
I've heard
about it before. I'm kind of familiar with it, I think.
Yeah, there's this one guy who's in this, you know, fucking farm-ass village, and he wants to move out to the big city. That's you, right? You're with your gamer gear, and all these guys are like, yeehaw!
Yeehaw!
Yeah.
We're gonna ride some cows or some fucking shit.
That dude. Hey, what state are you in, actually?
I'm in Missouri.
Missouri, alright. Missouri.
I think that's, like, considered, like, the most racist place in America or some shit. I don't know.
I bet you feel pretty out of place, right?
Yeah.
Like, fully integrated in society through the internet, right?
Yeah. And I'm just hanging around. I don't even know anybody around here. But I know they're all hillbillies. It's kind of funny.
You don't have any friends living near you?
No. Well, I mean, like, an hour away, but... Yeah. I actually visited them, like, what is today? Like, Sunday? I visited them Saturday and we went bowling, so that was fun.
Yeah, nice. But when we talked, you mentioned that you'd like to get away from it, right? It's not the ideal situation kind of thing.
Oh, yeah. I'm just sitting out here, sitting in my room every day, all that shit.
Well, you're making content. I feel like you are building a kingdom for yourself. Like, you were, like... I've seen your name around for a while because we were in like a bunch of like all artists are always in a bunch of servers, right, for some reason. And I think you have kind of like created a name for yourself, you know. You have built a kingdom, and maybe it's not, you know, maybe you're not like at your peak IRL, yeah, but at least you know you have like a backlog of shit built, right? You've been productive is what I'm trying to say. It's not like you were just sitting there, you know, getting drunk playing video games. I'm judging you.
Yeah.
No kidding.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess so. Done some stuff. I guess a few people know who me is.
Yeah. Like 30 people will probably watch this. So now they will.
Hi, people.
Hi, people.
Yeah.
What are your dreams, then? What would you like to do?
I just don't know. Just having fun making... Or not having fun making Minecraft shit.
Yeah, but come on.
If making you moved... a game, maybe.
All right. Would you do it here?
I don't have any. Huh?
Would you do it in the state?
Maybe. I'm thinking about just going around places, checking the world out, maybe. I don't know.
Come by the Netherlands, bro. It's a wild idea. Won't happen, but it's an invite. Open invite. If you ever become homeless, you know?
Yeah.
My girl will be like, who's this guy? That's Q-word.
It's me. Hi.
You look like a Q-word, though.
I look like a Q-word.
Yeah, I think Hubert makes fun. Makes sense for you. But I call you QB, like the letter Q and then the letter B. Is that QD?
QB. Hello, QB.
Hey, QB. Okay, this is kind of silly. I actually have notes, though. I came prepared, little bitch ass. Hungover ass piece of shit. Smoke weed! Weed doesn't get. Is weed legal in Missouri?
Nope.
Oh, shit, man.
Alright. Yeah, they have like some medical card stuff, but I'm
pretty sure you can just get it. Just say you're autistic.
Yeah, pretty much. That's pretty much how I think it goes. I honestly don't know. I haven't looked into that.
Hey, you've done it, but though.
Yeah, it's illegal other than that. Oh, no.
Oh, I thought you said you were gonna get a guy, or there was a guy that was like gonna. Oh.
Yeah, I couldn't find anybody, and I just got too lazy to even look around.
No, I get it. It's a weird one. Anyways. Oh, yeah. You want to talk about the Book of Boba? Because it's on my mind. And it's just, you know, it's just fading every day that goes by. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, sure. We can do that.
What do you think? How into Star Wars are you? What's your opinion on Star Wars as a whole? To lube us into the spoiler-filled conversation of the Book of Boba, now streaming on Disney Plus.
Now streaming on Disney Plus. I used to be in Star Wars big time when I was younger. Mm-hmm. But I think after they killed Han Solo, spoilers. After they killed Han Solo in whatever that fucking movie was.
The Last Jedi? The Last Jedi.
It was like The Force Awakens or something. I think after that point, I lost interest pretty big.
Are you a big Han Solo guy?
I don't really know. I don't really care about Star Wars that much these days, but I care about it enough to see what's happening with some of the stuff.
I think Star Wars lore is just really cool. Like, just the idea, not necessarily the lore, like, not necessarily how it's played out in the movies, but just the idea of it. Like, there's these lightsabers. It's just, like, classically cool, you know? What I mean? It's, like, lightsabers and then lightning, you know what I mean? And then fucking also robots and space, explosions. It's just cool. The lore of it, like, so much the force it. And the balance and the fucking... Yeah, it has so much to it. But The Mandalorian and the fucking Book of Boba, almost no force uses, which I also really appreciate. All the Jedi stuff is just out of here. Like, Jedis are like weird mythical creatures in these parts of the galaxy. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I actually like seeing that more. I like The Mandalorian. That show is amazing.
Yeah.
I'm really happy with how that came out. Just seeing, like, some character who's not attached to Luke Skywalker, the Skywalker saga stuff. I don't know. Just nice seeing somebody else playing some characters.
And he's really cool, right? Like, he's got the chrome armor. He's like he's like straight up everything Captain Phasma was trying to be, right? The chrome thing is so cool. It didn't work out. We gotta try again. And then they did. I'm glad they did. Bro, I was so inspired by the Mandalorian. That armor, the shiny Beskar armor, I'm nerding out so hard. It's so cool. I made it in what I was playing Fallout 4 back when that came out, and I made it in the game, you know what I mean? Like, tried to recreate it, whatever. I installed mods to make it chrome. That's so fucking cool, man. And then he's like riding all these creatures, and then he has this blaster and all these and then he has the cape, and now he has the jetpack. It's a wild one, man. I love it.
Yeah. I'm really happy how they built up his armory. Throughout the episodes, like, you didn't see him with a jetpack in the first season.
Yeah,
I think
100%.
But he got that. It was pretty cool to see him get that finally.
Yeah, the armor is epic, and you shouldn't just underestimate, you know, how he got it so far. It's really good.
Yeah, it's pretty wicked.
What was your favorite part of what did you think of Book of Boba? I don't think I let you finish that question actually.
Yeah, I think it was kind of bland, boring-ish.
Oh, really? You didn't like it?
Yeah, it was kind of slow. I was like, every time it went to the as interesting as the Tusken Raider stuff was,
it's just like you.
I kind of waited for it to get back to what was happening in, I guess, the current time.
Oh, no, I didn't necessarily have that. I thought the Tusken was one of my favorite bits, but carry on.
Yeah, it was pretty cool, I think. But I just wanted to see something else.
Mm. What were you hoping for?
I don't know, actually.
Because it's pretty vague, right? Book of Boba. But also, it's too specific. Yeah. If they called it something else, it would have been a much better show, right? Like Tales of Tatooine, I've heard on the nets.
That would be a good one, right?
Just straight up call it Tales of Tatooine and advertise it as such. Maybe don't show the Mandalorian, let that be like a secret. And then it's about... And then it doesn't even need to be like a weird flashback thing. Like the Wookiee part can just be a few episodes of the Tales of Tatooine, you know what I mean? Or not the Wookiees, the fucking... whatever they're called, Sky Raiders. No, what are they called? Tusken Raiders.
The Tusken Raiders, yeah. Yeah, that would be interesting. An anthology of stories that maybe build up to something.
Well, that's what this was, right? In my opinion.
Kind of. It was kind of just like Boba Fett was like, I guess he learned some shit from the Tuskens. Mm-hmm. And then they died, and then he's just like, okay, I guess I'll just go back to civilization and try that out again.
Yeah, no, I agree.
And he didn't stick with the Tusken lifestyle, which is it's okay, but I don't know.
Yeah, they didn't really explore why he wanted... I've heard that complaint a lot, like why he wanted to do it. Why he went straight, like, there wasn't, like, a super strong motivation. It's not like he became the king of whatever the fuck. It's not because... what's it called? Dalmir? What did they say? I'm the Dalmir of these parts. That's how he talks, right?
Dalmir? I don't think I've heard that.
That's probably not Dalmir. Dalmir? Mjolnir.
Oh, yeah. I do remember something like that. I can't remember what it exactly was.
But they don't really go into why he wants to do that. Is it because they killed the Tuskens? Is that like, I'm going to set it straight? He's not like, it would have been, for me, it would have been fine. I'm not saying it would have been better, but I would have been, I mean, maybe it would have been better. If he, you know, like, kind of did it for the Tuskens, right? If he, like, made that part of his, like, yo, we gotta integrate, we gotta stop killing the Tuscans, stop seeing them as the enemy, you know what I mean? If that was, like, a political thing, like, change maybe he was trying to make, I think, you know, it would have been, it, I don't know.
It would have been more interesting, yeah.
Because yeah, easy to say
he
that.
Just shows up randomly to this, Jabba, what was the, Bib Fortuna?
Yeah, Bib Fortuna was Jabba's second hand, who then became the guy once Jabba was killed. But Jabba just hired Boba, right? Like, I don't know why he has a grudge.
Yeah, he did.
Maybe he just feels like the other guy, Bib Fortuna, doesn't deserve it. I don't know. Well, yeah, it's a bit of a, that's a weak one. What did you think? By the way, my favorite part of the Book of Boba was, I was so fucking hyped for this. When I watched this, I was like, I was so hyped. And I hope in some way you must agree with me. The train episode, where it builds up and they're in this desert, right? Reduce the fucking, like, you know, fucking painting with shit or whatever Tuscans do, right? With fighting with sticks and whatever. And then suddenly there's this massive train that just shoots lasers and there's nothing they can fucking do, right? And that sets like a certain bar. And then it gets paid off by the Tuscans then stealing the fucking thingies from the biker gang, the shitty biker gang, right? The motorcycles. And chase sequence was so fucking cool. And the Tuscans, like, fucking, I don't know, dog. That gets me hyped to shit. I thought it was a good show.
It was a good episode.
How would you rate the show?
I don't know. I don't know how rating that works. It'd probably be like maybe a 6 out of 10 for me.
Six out of ten?
Is it just that episode or the entire show?
I mean, was that episode a 6 out of 10 for you?
Well, that was just for the whole show. I don't know.
Okay. No, the whole show. 6 out of 10. Fair. That's fair. Okay, fair.
Okay. Yeah.
I would say 7.5 out of 10. It's pretty high.
Maybe
7.4. You know what I mean?
Yeah. It wasn't bad, but could have been better.
I agree with you that it was very slow. Like, there was one episode about where he builds a spaceship, right? And that was so, like, I feel like it was building up to something. Like, I don't know. It was so weird to watch that happen. Like, it was so, why are we watching this? Like, and it's fine, because I get it. It's a show, and they have a budget, and they have big sequences, cost a lot of money. It's not like a, for me, it's not a big deal, but I do get where you're coming from.
Yeah.
But I guess it's for the nerds, right? Because I saw a lot of people online who were really into Star Wars, and they're like, oh my god, they used this piece, and that was also the same piece in this place. So now this piece has a name. You know what I mean? Like, the turbo flux capacitor. Hand me the thingy. And then there's a robot from, like, a game. You know what I mean? All the nerds are like, oh my god, this robot is now canon. I think that
episode. Oh, yeah, I did hear about that. That was funny.
Yeah.
I like how they just put little references in there from, like, other stuff.
Yeah, me too. I'm just not invested enough in Star Wars, you know what I mean?
Yeah, me too. I didn't know half the shit in there, or that they referenced. It's just like, oh, I do see a lot of things in there. It's like, oh, that's something I've not seen before, which is kind of cool that they're still adding to it.
Like
I think
what?
They have, like, I think they had the Boston Dynamic robots in there.
Actually, oh, yeah, they did. Yeah, they did. Yeah, that's fun. Yeah.
That was fun. Also, there's a, I guess they just keep expanding on it. Like the ant droids in the second Mandalorian episode.
Yeah, what did it do though? What's that about? I didn't really get that. That felt like a really big moment. Like, these droids building this thing, but I didn't really get
that. Yeah, the ant droids, the droids that look like ants that were building, like, the, I guess, a Jedi temple. Jedi temple.
Exactly, yeah.
It's just something new. That was pretty interesting.
Oh, yeah, see. I guess it was, yeah. Totally. Yeah. By the way, the Luke Skywalker CGI was, I would argue, it's perfect. I don't know if you know, I'm not a professional fucking, you know, but I'm a viewer. I just watch it, and I was completely fooled. The only thing that was throwing me off was my own mind going, this guy's dead. Well, he's not dead.
Yeah.
But he's, like, old, you know what I mean?
Yeah. That's what I was... I mean, it was... It's pretty real. It was pretty cool to see that.
Improvement, at least, right? From
Mandalorian. Oh, yeah, yeah. I didn't even see a problem with it or hear a problem. I think the only problems people had was the audio from Luke Skywalker. It was like robotic-y or something. I only watched it once, and my first view of it was like, no, this is pretty real. It's pretty good.
Yeah, for real. I mean, I'm sure it was robotic-y. I mean, I'm sure it's completely fake, right? Or maybe, couldn't they hire a voice actor, though?
Yeah, I think they did audio. They did like a AI, audio AI thing to recreate it instead of hiring a voice actor.
That's wild. We're in the era now, right? Where fucking actors can just not exist, right? You don't need actors. You just have a human. You know what I mean?
Yeah. It's kind of strange.
Yeah, that's pretty fucking strange. It's kind of
cool to see, though. It's pretty
it is. Especially, like, my girl said this about Endgame. Like, we've been watching all the fucking Marvel movies, right? She had never seen any. And I was like, okay, we can date, but only if you see the Marvel movies. She was like, okay, fine. And we watched Endgame recently. No, Endgame. No, we watched also Endgame recently, but this wasn't about Endgame. This was about Spider-Man No Way Home. Right, because that's the first Marvel movie. Are you into all this shit?
Probably not as invested as you, I guess. I've seen like all the movies pretty much, but
I don't remember what I was gonna say. Anyways, it doesn't matter. It's fine. Get high and you lose your train of thought. And I am gonna smoke another joint, actually.
God damn,
dude! How do you party? You just video game? What else do you do?
Yeah, I don't know. Sometimes I do hang out with other folks, just listening to music, playing some, I guess, pool. We play some pool sometimes.
Yeah, that's pretty cool though.
Yeah. Some good old times, good old fashioned hanging out.
What are your hobbies besides pool and obviously Minecraft? It's fine to have two hobbies, by the way. What?
Oh, yeah. I guess it's just art, man. Yeah. Two hobbies.
Yeah, that's pretty good hobbies.
Art in general. I have wanted to start a lot of hobbies, but, like, I have a pound of clay sitting over on my dresser over there that's not been touched for, like, 5 years.
Yeah, well, that's fine. It's part of the lore.
It's part of the lore, yeah.
Maybe at some point you can sell it, like, art that never became itself, you know what I mean? By Kubert.
Yeah, I suppose. I'm trying to actually get it wet because it's been dried out for so long.
Same, dude. You have no idea how relatable it is.
Yeah.
Oh man.
Gosh, dude, it's so fucking relatable.
Okay, let me get back to my notes. All right, QB. Okay. Silly QB. I thought that the final episode fucking rocked, right? Of the Book of Boba.
Yeah, that was pretty cool.
So much enthusiasm. It was pretty cool. Would you not say it? The big droids, right? With the shields. I thought it was very well paced. There was so much action, but it all made sense. Like, they kind of established these corners of the streets where everything is happening, right? And then there's this region, that region. You know,
yeah,
it's kind of some racism there, but that was fine. You know, I got over it. I got really angry watching it. I was gonna write a tweet, but then I got over it.
Mm-hmm. But I think the droids were cool, but I think the funniest thing watching that entire sequence was what the people were like running away, but those droids walk so slowly that it's just like, can you not get away from that?
Yeah, they could. I didn't forget why they didn't go into houses. I kept thinking.
Yeah, that too. Like, they could have just dodged into there. Like, they can't shoot. I guess they weren't going to shoot through buildings because they weren't doing that.
Because it took them a long time, right? As we saw in the end, it took them a long time eventually to shoot down the building. Yeah, and you could literally, like, go from, instead of running like this through the streets, just go from house, like, through like this. I don't know. They're just like, and the droid has to go like this because it's so huge, right? I thought that would be the move.
Yeah.
But that's fine.
And it can go, like, through, it can only go through the main streets, too. It can't go through, like, alleyways.
Yeah, that's
it
what I'm saying.
It destroys buildings, but it doesn't do that. So.
Well, maybe it could climb over it. It's a pretty cool droid design. That's a new droid design, probably, right? I mean, I've never seen that in anything.
I think it. nerd moment. I think it was actually. Yeah.
That's hilarious.
I watched a video and I saw some people were like, it's in a comic or something.
Okay. That was a real nerd moment.
Yeah.
Nerd moment with
beard. I hate doing that because it's just like, I know this shit, but it's just like, I don't want to be a fucking nerd.
No,
like, I don't care that much about it, but it's just like, I happen to know shit.
Yeah, you can sometimes. Be a nerd though. I'm a little bit of a nerd. But wait, you know what the problem is with all these labels, Qbert? They don't define us, don't they? We're above all that shit.
Yeah. I'm not a nerd. I'm a Qbert. Fuck it. Yeah.
You're just quirky like that.
So I'm such a quirky gamer.
I really like that voice. The other one. Fucking, actually?
Actually?
Yeah.
Your mom.
Actually, I fucked your mom. I fucked your mother. Okay, I got notes, Qbert. I actually have so many notes, Jesus Christ. Oh, what did you think of the mod kids?
The mod kids.
Right? The fucking,
they were cool.
Power Rangers? You thought they were cool?
They're whatever. I don't give a shit. I'm sure you could find... It's odd that they were in that... On that planet, I guess. You wouldn't expect to see people like that on the planet. Because you have to be, like...
It was never really
to even get parts like that, I suppose.
Yeah, that's what I think, too. But I guess it could be a model, right? It could just be, it could just be a big company that sells them, right, in their defense.
Yeah.
Or I guess they make them themselves, right? That's their whole deal. Don't they pimp them themselves? Because they're... You know what I thought was weird? That they're all, like, go-go gadgeted up, right? They have, like...
Yeah.
They're so, like... I don't know, man.
That one girl who has the metal arm, I guess it's just better strength, I guess. I don't know. She's got, like, a regular hand, too, so that was kind of interesting.
You know what my theory is, though? I'll tell you my honest theory, and I think I might be right, because I'm just the best fucking calculator in the minds of in the world. Fucking listen to this, right? These guys, Disney is going to do a kids show. A Star Wars kids show, like a Disney Channel type shit, right? Just adults pretending to be kids, and it's like PG content, obviously, right? You know what I mean? Like the whole shebang.
Yeah.
And they're going to do it in a Star Wars universe, maybe on Tatooine, with these kids, right?
Mm-hmm.
And because they're super PG, they're quirky, they're like, woohoo, you know, they don't bleed because then they get they get parts replaced, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? They can lose an arm, but it's just a part, whatever.
Yeah.
I swear to God, that's my theory.
That could be a fun little show for the little kiddies, little kiddos.
And then you have the nerd watching it, like.
And then there would be that one person, that one nerd watching it. But we don't do labels because we're quirky.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Sorry, I'm quick to jump to the nerd part. Oh, finish my beers.
Yeah.
No, I haven't. Hey, cheers, mate. Drinking beer at 1:30 in the afternoon for you.
Yeah, that would be fun. I don't even know if I have any right now to drink.
It says you're homeschooled. Are you doing up? This is the one question that I keep forgetting to ask. Are you in school?
No, I've been out of school for like 3-5. What year is this? We're in 2022.
Yeah.
It's been like 3-4 years. Yeah,
oh my God.
Haven't done much. What?
Wait, is today... No. Oh, I missed 2022 Tuesday. Oh. That's what I'm saying. Wait, is today Wednesday? No.
What is it? I think it's Tuesday.
But,
You did miss the 2222, though.
Oh, that was in February. February is the second month. Sorry, I'm R-worded. Jesus Christ. Anyways, sorry.
You can still make 3333 though. That's coming up in
yeah, but it's not 2020. It's not 3000 or 3033, right?
I don't think the 2000 counted, did it? I think it was just the end 22. It was like February 22nd, 2022. I don't know. I think only the end.
That was the one. But you couldn't do that, right? Ever again for like a century, because it has to be 3033.
I guess. But it's, yeah, I don't know. Like it'll be 3. Oh no, you can't fucking do that. I don't know what I'm talking about. I saw that somewhere. I guess I got tricked.
You got bamboozled, QB?
Because there's I just stopped and I'm like, there's no 33. Yeah, I did actually get fucked there.
It's fine. We all get fucked sometimes.
Yeah.
Not me. I'm the fucker usually, but that's fine. Do you want to talk about fucking the real fucker here, which is obviously Putin, Vladimir Putin, the UK, Ukraine crisis? You can talk about that, right, on YouTube, I'm pretty sure.
I don't know. Probably. They have videos up on YouTube.
You know what? Yeah, but I think they're keeping it up for, like, cover, or for, like, you know, evidence, maybe, even, right? You know, I went on Omegle, or Oma TV today, and I met some guys from Russia, and because you can just select the country you're in, right? And I'm like, holy shit, I can literally just talk to Russians as this is happening, right? And Ukrainians as well, but there's almost no Ukrainians on the internet except for kids, right? Because their parents are like, no, here, take the phone or whatever, and I don't want to like talk about with them about the war, right? But I met these Russian guys, right? And I asked them, we just had a conversation, like, yeah, I'm from the Netherlands, I smoke weed, you know, whatever. Hey, hey, and they're like, oh, you know, crazy. And then I asked about Ukraine, and they said, they're our brothers, right? They have no quarrel with them, basically, is what they said to me. And then I asked about Putin and stuff, I started asking questions, and they went like this, no talk. They went like this, right?
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh shit, dude, this is too real. You know what I mean? Like, this is not fun. Yeah. Like, I mean, I don't know, it was a fine interaction, but yeah, shit's wild, man. Shit's absolutely fucking bonkers. And why is it?
It's actually kind of scary.
Why does this feel? You've been following this, right?
A little bit, yeah. I mean, like, I don't know what's been happening recently. I know a lot of people died.
Civilians died. Now. Did you see the picture of civilians being missiled? They got fucking blown up.
Yeah, I did.
You saw the picture? It was wild, dude.
Yeah. It's really sad.
Yeah, it is really sad. I'm constantly in RSS Ukraine. It's the wildest thing ever. I don't know why I'm still into like this war. I think it is also fear, because I know that this is a guy. Like, I would be just as fearful if we suddenly had to quarrel with fucking North Korea, right? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's just the type of fucking guy, this crazy fucking religious maniac, right? The sociopath sitting in his little fucking cabin, like, oh, apparently he's all scared of coronavirus, you know what I mean? Like, oh, and then he's making all these wild decisions. And he has nukes. Did you know that Ukraine gave all their nukes to Russia for safekeeping, I guess, or whatever the fuck?
Yeah.
As a peace treaty, right? This was the peace treaty. Give your nukes to us, and we'll fucking. And this is probably part of Putin's crazy fucking plan that he has, because he's a sociopath. He has like this really long term plan. So do I, but mine is about YouTube. His is about conquering the world, right? Literally, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
And like them giving Ukraine, giving them the nukes, just was straight up just part of this sociopathic plan. To just have this guy on this planet with that much power. And Europe is kind of close, you know? Like, if they're gonna fucking nuke a civilized area, I mean, obviously it would be Ukraine, but next to it might be Europe. Who knows? It's closer by, you know? Fucking Poland, get some shit, bitches. I don't know, man. This shit creeps me the fuck out sometimes, you know? I think about this shit. Worries me.
It's kind of scary.
Yeah, civilians being bombed.
Yeah, I feel it's just I wonder what the Russian military thought it was a drill or something. Was that the case? And they just
I don't doubt that that's what they said, that it was a drill, and then they shot at the fucking they accidentally shot in the middle of the Freedom Square, Ukraine. I don't doubt that the Russians claimed that that was real. Or what are you talking about?
Well, I think, I don't know where I heard this. I don't know where I read it, but I thought I heard. I don't know. I haven't been on Reddit at all.
Oh.
But it's just like I thought I heard they were directing the army that they were doing a drill at the border of Ukraine, and it was just a drill or something, and the people in the army, the Russian army, didn't know that it was going to be an invasion. I don't know if that's...
Right. I get you. From what I hear, it's also the case that the Russian people, like... I saw this one story of, like, a Russian soldier, and he was being told that they would meet the Ukrainians with flowers, right? Like, the Ukrainians would be offering flowers, like, yes, fucking whatever the fuck mission they were on, like, this freedom mission, whatever Putin is, like, directing this as, the fucking psychopath that he is, obviously, right?
Yeah.
Like, the Russian soldiers are delusioned into it, right? Like, this is how scared the Russian people are, bro. I talked to those guys. We could barely communicate. He did this to me, right? And I get what he means. And I bet he's serious about it. He's not, like, bullshitting me. He's on the camera from Russia, you know? Like...
Yeah.
It's wild, man. It's
fucking... I wonder how close they monitor that kind of stuff.
Right now, they're probably busy fighting off all the anonymous fucking shit. But I wouldn't be surprised... Honest MJ take. I wouldn't be surprised if have you seen the anonymous stuff, like the videos and that the anonymous has posted?
I don't think so.
You need to watch this. I'll tab into the KKK for this. Okay, hold up. What was I talking about? Sorry, I got high and I forget what I was saying.
I don't even remember, to be honest.
I gotta remember. Hubert, you gotta help me out.
It was... Something anonymous?
Yes! Come on, QB, it wasn't that hard. You got it right away! Okay. Check this out. I'm gonna send you a video. And you're gonna watch it, and I'm gonna watch it also, and I'm recording, so it'll just record, okay? So, no problem. Oh, wait, this might be the link to the Discord message. Wait, hold up, I'll see if that works. This is so
okay.
Fucking...
Yeah, quirk. That works. So what is this video? Or is this a video? Yeah.
No, hold up.
Oh, that.
Are you seeing it? Anonymous hacks Russian TV to show footage from the...
Yeah.
Oh, wait, that's not
I
the one.
I didn't watch what that was, but I heard about it happen, potentially happening.
No, I'm sorry, I'm a goofball. I got the right one for you now. Okay, I'm gonna watch this, okay?
Yeah.
The courage of Ukrainians gives us the necessary strength to fight. Their will is simply remarkable, and Anonymous presents them with the greatest respect. We are with you.
Feels like a weird... Is this like the entire clip of what they sent, or... Hacked into a TV? Did they hack into a TV station?
Yeah, that's what they've claimed, yeah. But I don't know how much it's propaganda, because I'm sure America does propaganda too, right?
Yeah. I haven't watched any of the TVs or the TV stations, so I don't know.
Me neither.
What they have going on.
Yeah, me neither.
I don't know if I should. They're probably going wild.
Yeah, you wouldn't understand it though, right?
Yeah.
I wouldn't really want to participate in anything like this.
Isn't this the wildest thing ever?
Do you have any choice?
The music? Yeah. It's so epic. It's almost like... And then Zelensky is this perfect guy, you know?
Yeah.
When I heard the explosion, I decided that I'm ready. I'm an adult woman, I'm healthy, it's my responsibility.
Imagine fighting for your country, bro.
Yeah.
Люди тільки йдуть і підтримують, тільки хвалять, і щоб хтось переживав за те, що ми зброю. Я за сутки останні
Yeah, okay, this is really long. You get the fucking... how long is this? 2 minutes. I just have to see the ending of it. Are you still watching it?
Yeah, I'm still watching it.
Okay, great.
I kind of skipped ahead.
Oh, shit. Have you seen the ending of it? Like the Anonymous logo?
Yeah, it's kind of weird.
It is kind of weird.
It's like, was this like made during the whole war after the invasion? Or it's kind of cheesy.
It is kind of cheesy. But Anonymous, theoretically, Anonymous is just the organization is just a symbol, right? They have you get a mask, a black fucking hoodie, get a fucking VPN, and you do your shit. You do your shit, right? In the name of of good, I guess, right? That's what you try to do. That's what the whole fucking movement is about, right? So theoretically, sending out the message, right, yo, Anonymous, all the fucking people, if you can hack, right, get in there, right, sending that message, you know, is in the favor of NATO, right, the West, if I can say the West, you know, the good guys, yeah. I'd say, right, I'm pretty sure everyone agrees Putin is a bad guy, right, I don't think I need to, like...
Everybody who has a better interest into not having a war with another country, I suppose. I don't know if I said
not even that though, because even people that are like neutral, well, I guess you couldn't stay neutral if someone's nuking, right? But did you see that Switzerland changed up their stance on the Ukraine thing?
Oh, I didn't see that, I don't think.
Because Switzerland is also always, like, classically, Switzerland is always passive, or what's called neutral, right? You know, the classic Switzerland, right? I'm gonna put a Switzerland, whatever. Imagine being so much the bad guy. Imagine being Putin, right? And you're so much the bad guy that
Switzerland, a famously neutral country, turns against you.
What the fuck was I gonna say? I'm sorry, dude. Oh, fucking. What the fuck was I talking about? This must be horrible. Anyone watching this? 46 minutes in. Fuck was I gonna say? Help me out here. Putin is so much the bad guy. Yeah.
I don't know where you were going with that. That's all I remember.
I'll just say it. I'll just finish the thought afterwards and just edit it, and we'll carry on like nothing happened. Anyways, moving on to my list. Putin has kind of. Oh yeah, what now? What do you think, Hubert? What now? Putin has definitely crossed the line, right? Even if we get him fucking nailed down, right? We have him in there, we arrest him, right? And like, and then what? America, of like, someone just takes over? Zelensky should do it, right?
The guy. Will he even be alive to be arrested? Are they gonna do another body burning like they did with Hitler? And like, all I can remember is Hitler. I don't remember if that happened with anybody else in World War II, but...
You think it's a mistake to lock a guy like Putin up?
I don't know. I honestly don't know.
Maybe you're right, maybe. Maybe it is.
He could go to jail, he could be... If he goes to jail, he'll probably be put to death, maybe? For starting a war in the first place? I don't know what they did with
He is responsible for the nukes, right? He called the shots.
He started the invasion. Started everything.
Well, he has a puppet probably in Belarus, right? Belarus is like just their little slave or whatever, and it's in between Ukraine, right? And that's how they communicate or whatever. But Belarus is now also sending missiles, so they're straight up two countries. Anyways, do you know about Putin's sacred quest?
No, I don't. Putin, what does that entail? Tell me.
Yes, I will. I have notes. This is great shit. MJ Trips, fucking 48 minutes in. Here we are, the best part of the podcast. Putin is from Leningrad, born of a devout Christian mom who baptized him in secret. Right. So he's like this all like, oh, fucking, you know, shebang. Putin, and he sees himself as a true defender of Christianity, right? That's his whole like mental shebang, fucking schizo, whatever fuck, psychosis, whatever the fuck is going on there, right? He sees himself as like, yo, I'm the fucking, he might even think that he's talking to God. Who knows? You know what I mean? He's this crazy fucking guy, right? Huge ego, obviously. this article that I read, I'll link it in the description below. You can read it if you want, because I don't know how true this is. I just read some. How the fuck do I know? You know what I mean? Well, anyways.
Yeah.
This article says that bombing ISIS, which is what Putin did a bunch of times, was apparently to cast as the defense of the historical homeland of Christianity, right? That area. Just like, yo, get the fuck out of here with your religion, because this is my religion. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Same for Ukraine, because in Ukraine is where, in 988... Vladimir of Rus, this is like a biblical fucking guy, right? Probably was baptized, or like a real guy. I don't actually know. So Ukraine is actually where he was baptized, right? Like a big fucking deal. And Putin is on a spiritual quest, and he's gonna burn the world in the process. But he also unites it. There you go.
That's interesting.
You like my notes on that?
I didn't even know he was, I guess, religious.
Well, maybe he uses it as a. Just like to get people to fucking be with him, maybe, because a lot of politicians do that, right?
Yeah. I don't know. Sounds like the Hitler thing when you, like, I don't know if it's just like a, I don't know if it's an actual historical thing, but like Hitler going around collecting religious artifacts or something.
That happened?
I don't know. I think he did go around collecting artifacts, but like, I honestly don't know.
It could have just been for his own personal collection, right? Like, if I was a fucking, if I had the ego to conquer fucking the world, right?
Yeah. He did take a lot of things. I don't know if they, I know they weren't like fucking religious shit, or they needed, it wasn't for the magic and religious shit, like all these stupid
movies. It's wild, right?
Stuff portraying. Like Indiana Jones, or
right.
Whatever movie that was. But yeah, he did go around collecting artifacts. I guess that's kind of what that article would be saying about Putin, of sorts.
It's kind of like a Red Skull in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, right?
Red Skull.
He gets the Tesseract, right?
Yeah, it's another one of those Nazi stories of them collecting random artifacts.
Yeah. So wild one. It's fucking wild, dude. I don't know, man. Ukraine is it's a fucking thing in itself, right? I mean, I hope for the best, but have you seen the convoy? The, like, apparent, like, allegedly 40-mile convoy, which seems like propaganda or maybe, like, a typo. I don't know, dog. But there's a... Let's say it's 4 miles. That's still a pretty long convoy. Are you with me, QB?
Yeah.
QB of like, I don't know, sorry, a convoy of like tanks and like, I don't know, you know, probably tanks, right? Coming into Ukraine. I imagine that is kind of an issue.
Is it a Russian convoy? Is it just...
Yeah, into Ukraine, yeah.
Oh, okay.
So they're like...
Yeah.
That's happening now, which is a wild one.
I'm surprised this whole fucking thing even happened. Mm. Like,
and it's so stupid, too, right?
Yeah, it's stupid. I don't even know why he's wanting Ukraine or invading it. It's just like, it's kind of fucking stupid. But, like, there's people who are getting killed, and it's just like, fucking stupid.
Makes me really angry, man.
It's not worth lives and shit.
No, this one guy this billionaire with a huge ego and like a tiny penis, and he's like has all the power just because he took it. Like it makes no. It's that's something to get angry about, you know.
Yeah.
The high MJ take.
The high MJ take.
Yeah, I just want to check in with you. How are you doing? We're 54 minutes in. I personally am gonna finish my weed for the week and then not buy any more until I go on a holiday, which is coming up to Groningen. I'm going with my girlfriend. It's gonna be fun because I'm the chef right now in the office I work at. I do everything. I order, you know, I got the whole fucking shebang. I'm pretty fucking responsible, and it's going well. Today was kind of a chaotic day. we were supposed to have cold potato salad, and when you make a potato salad, you steam the potatoes beforehand, the day before, right? And then you, maybe you, and then my plan was to bake them so they're also kind of crispy, right? And then let them cool off in the fridge, and the next day you make the salad, right? But the potatoes didn't come in the order that I made, and I did order them, I didn't forget, they just didn't come. And it's so dumb to me, right? Because this company that brings the order, why don't they just fucking replace it with another type of potato? Like, I clicked, sorry, this is so dumb, but I clicked one type. I need to get this on my chest, okay, QB. I clicked a specific type of potato in the order list, right? It's like this little program I'm on my laptop, right? I have this own, I could turn it around. It's like a fucking tablet, right? It's a really fancy Chromebook. It's not mine. It's the company's. But anyways, I feel pretty fancy, right? I feel pretty important. You with me, QB? Yeah. And I clicked the potato brand, but you can just give me any potato, right? Like, why do you just go, sorry, that potato isn't available. Now you have no potatoes, right? That's kind of silly. Anyways, I solved it. Because there's a company that delivers fruit separately, a separate company, and they also, you know, have potatoes. So they got potatoes for me. Great. So it was fine. You know, solved it. No problem. But, you know, fucking chaos.
Yeah.
I don't know where that rant came from. Sorry. Oh, yeah. I was checking in with you. How are you doing?
Potatoes. Doing pretty good.
Yeah?
Yeah. Doing pretty neat.
Do you want to... How long do you want to go on for? I can go longer, but I don't know how much you're enjoying this. You gotta be enjoying it, you know? If you're thinking, yeah, this guy's getting weird.
This guy's fucking smoking too much fucking weed. He's going insane.
I'd argue you're not smoking enough weed, but alright.
Got it. Yeah, that's probably true. I'd probably be in a better mood to actually be talking a bit more. If I was like drunk, or not drunk, just even buzzed right now, I'll be into the conversations a bit more. Well, I don't know whether what I would be saying.
Do you want to end the podcast? It's an hour is good. An hour is a great podcast. That's a long podcast. People don't watch this anyways. It's already too long. People watch. If I upload a 10-minute podcast, people watch it, get 100 views. If I upload the type of content I want to make, I want people to watch, I get 30 views. It's fine though. You know, I'm forcing my way through to what I want to make, right? Building my community. It's fine. Yeah.
You should do like some clips, like little clips of conversations in here. Oh, do you?
Yeah, I do. I have a clips channel. You haven't seen my clips channel? I have a clips channel.
No, I didn't. I haven't seen that. I should find that. I didn't know that.
Yeah. I'm hustling, man. Creating my own look. But, yeah, let's end it, buddy. It's been a great podcast. I'm going to smoke the last of my weed on my own. Editing this, probably, right? Because I got to be out by Sunday. Sunday fun day, so far. I like Sunday fun day. Sunday. Yeah. You excited to be on MDA trips?
Yeah. Pretty cool. Second try's pretty good.
Second try's pretty good. First try was kind of racist. You can check it out on the clips channel. I put the clip on the clips channel of the racist fucking joke. Because that was epic. Yeah. That in his own was really fucking funny. To me, watching it back. But I don't know, man. It's really... Don't worry, QB. It's like 57 minutes into the episode. No one's watching. My uncle doesn't even watch my episodes, I'm pretty sure. He comments on every one of them. But I'm pretty sure he thinks, this is too long, man. Fuck out of here.
Yeah, but it's hard for people to try to watch an hour long thing.
Yeah, or have an hour long conversation, right?
Hour long conversation that just keeps going so many different directions.
I know, right? I'm sorry, dude. Thank you though for being a guest on my show. I really appreciate your time.
Yeah, no problem.
Oh, hold up. I'm a professional. Check out Hubert. He's got this fancy little link. thecubert.card.co. Got his fucking Twitter out here, his Instagram, his YouTube. You can check it all out. Commission info. You can commission him. Are you doing commissions right now? Do you have any slots available as of this?
Ooh, maybe. We'll see.
Alright. No commitment. That's cool. You know, you figure it out. Send him a message though, you know? Hit him up. Give him a follow. Cubert. Thanks, my guy.
Hit me up. Send me some money just for fun, just for the heck of it.
You know, not too much, cool, not too much money. Send me some money too, you know?
Yes.
Find some really some money. Rich Russian billionaire who like has a conscience to give us some money. Both of us, you know?
Yeah. That'd be cool.
Fuck yeah, dude. I got him. All right, hey, I'm gonna end the podcast by hanging up the conversation. So I'll genuinely thanks for doing this. I'll see you around. Have a good life. We'll stay in touch. KKK always forever. You know.
Yeah.
See you, buddy. Ciao.
See you. Bye.
Ciao.
Zing.